What does entropy mean to you? If you've been to university or just YouTube self-educated, you probably have an opinion on entropy, albeit an uncertain one. Entropy is disorder and it always increases. Entropy is the reason for the arrow of time and the universe's ultimate death, somehow. While YouTube and textbooks do a good job with the concepts, what exactly is entropy? Like, not just what it is conceptually, but what it means on a physical, mathematical, predictive level. What proofs and intuitions are unlocked by understanding it? What do black holes, brains, and gases have in common? That's what I want to talk about today. Entropy has three distinct interpretations: thermodynamic, statistical, and information. Let's start with the first use of entropy, its thermodynamic definition. In the early 1800s, a physicist, Nicolas Carnot, was investigating the maximum efficiency of engines. From school, we learned that the total energy is conserved, never destroyed. But like batteries run out, something else is being used up when we spend energy to do work. It turns out, energy only does work when it moves. This is a problem, as energy only flows from high to low concentrations. We don't see heat flowing from cold to hot things, after all. Therefore, how energy is arranged in a system determines the amount of usable, free energy. There's a note on the definition of free energy which you can read here. To calculate free energy, we should first define the unusable energy. This is done with entropy. Entropy is how spread out the system's energy is, and can only increase as energy always spreads out. Its value is approximately the number of unusable molecules in the system. Temperature is the average energy per molecule. Multiplying them gives the amount of unusable energy. Therefore, just subtracting temperature times entropy from the total energy gives us the equation for free energy. F equals to U minus TS, where U is the total energy, T is the temperature, and S is entropy. This is one of the first mathematically precise definitions of entropy, and was used by Carnot to put an upper bound on the efficiency of engines. As entropy can't ever decrease, the highest efficiency an engine can achieve with a hot and cold side temperature of TH and TC is 1 minus TC over TH. Little did Carnot know that his definition was about to evolve far beyond his wildest dreams. In the late 1800s, theoretical physicists got the crazy idea that gas was made of tiny molecules, called the kinetic theory of gases. This was so crazy that one of its main believers, Ludwig Boltzmann, was risking his university position from being vocally in support. The existing theory assumed gas was a perfect fluid. To rectify this, he had to find a prediction that only a kinetic theory would make. Consider two gases of different temperatures mixing in a box. Over time, the temperatures of the two gases should equal. While thermodynamics just states temperature flows from hot to cold as a law, kinetic theory gives us a reason. Gas particles collide regularly with each other. In kinetic theory, heat isn't a unique energy, but the kinetic energy of gas particles. Colliding particles exchange energy, therefore regular colliding spreads out that thermal energy throughout the box. I'm about to go through the proof. It's nice, but you don't have to perfectly understand it to finish the video. For a set of particles with total energy U, particle positions and velocities can be arranged in many ways. Each configuration is called a microstate. The number of microstates with a total energy U is WU. Colliding particles can be seen as shuffling energy around a system, randomly picking from the distribution of microstates. With enough collisions, shuffles, each microstate is equally likely, but there are literally 10 to the power of 100 times more microstates where energy is spread out throughout a system then concentrated into one particle. Basically, with frequent enough collisions, we are overwhelmingly likely to see the number of microstates at its maximum. When mixing two gases, the number of combined microstates is WU1 times WU2, and this too should be maximized. To maximize the number of microstates, we set the derivative with respect to energy to zero. This is only true if this equation is true for both gases. Gases mixed by chance must have the same temperature. We've just proved probability alone reproduces the nature of temperature. Not only that, we can go a step further. Comparing the microstate equation with the one for free energy, we can define entropy entirely through probability. Two of the laws of thermodynamics have been made redundant. Boltzmann had achieved his goal. The kinetic model predicts an alternative definition of entropy, not of energy, but of probability. It was this equation that convinced the world that atoms could really exist, leading to the definitive proof in 1909, 3 years after Boltzmann's death. As a symbol of his legacy, his entropy equation is carved into his tombstone. We now have two perspectives on entropy: the arrangement of energy and probability. Let's see the third. Consider these three pieces of information. Their birthday lands on a day in a year, their birthday is in the summer, and their birthday is on a 25th. We see different statements convey different amounts of information. The first fact conveys nothing, the second fact cuts possible dates in a quarter, and the third fact cuts the probability in about 1 in 30. More than that, combining facts 2 and 3 gives a multiplicatively better constraint on the birthday. The second and third facts together give a combined constraint of 1 in 120. We can therefore interpret information as how much of a constraint it gives to pure randomness. The simplest information is a true or false statement, a bit, binary digit, of information. The number of bits, or other bases, needed to encode information is called the information content, Q, which is equal to minus k log p, where p is the probability that the information constrains, and k is a positive constant. Different values of k sets the arbitrary log powers for different bases. For instance, q equals to log 2p gives the information in the number of bits, and q equals to log 26p is in units of lowercase letters. How is this relevant to entropy? Well, let's see what happens when we make statements on reality, also known as measurements. A set of measurements can be considered as a full set of statements. Each statement in this set has an associated probability, pi, and hence information content, qi equals to negative k log pi. When we make a measurement, we randomly sample these statements by their probability. Therefore, the expected information gain is equal to the weighted average of the statement's information content. This is Shannon entropy, and is the average information content gained by sampling a full set of statements. In the case of measurements, Shannon's entropy is that measured quantity's uncertainty before measurement. We can see this when comparing two dice, one fair, one weighted. The fair die has a higher Shannon entropy than the weighted die, because we can expect the result of the weighted die before measurement. Entropy is greatest when information is best hidden. You might have noticed it already, but the formula for information entropy is identical to the thermodynamic entropy. This isn't too big of a leap, as we've just equated information to probability, and we know thermodynamics is just probability. It turns out, by treating gas as a bank of information, we create all of thermodynamics! Precisely, the process of temperature equilibrium is identical to a gas hiding its position and velocity information as efficiently as possible. But not only is thermodynamics just information, but information can be written as thermodynamics. Imagine a storage device at temperature T with n bits of information. Imagine we erased all that information, setting all the bits to zero. This removes n bits of information. So entropy decreases by nkb ln 2. For the total entropy of the universe to increase, the surrounding entropy must increase by nkb ln 2. And therefore, heat equal to at least nkbt ln 2 must be dissipated. Kbt ln 2 for each bit erased. Just forgetting information is a thermodynamic process. Entropy connects the world of information to the world of thermodynamics. There's a quote in maths and physics that sends a shiver down my spine. Whenever you have two mathematical ways of looking at the same thing, magic is about to happen. The power of entropy is in its many interpretations. Paradoxically, what makes entropy confusing to learn is also its power, allowing for crazy proofs. Here are a few of my favorites. Black holes have a temperature due to their entropy, and while you can derive it rigorously using Hawking's derivation, here is a simple proof. Imagine a black hole of diameter A. We assume the entropy of things entering the black hole is conserved. The smallest unit of information that can be lost in a black hole is the polarization, up or down, of a photon with wavelength A. By building a black hole from a Planck-length photon, the smallest black hole that can exist, we can find that the entropy is proportional to the surface area of the black hole. S equals to kBa over 4L squared, where L is the Planck length, and A is the area of a black hole. Entropy is proportional to black hole area. That's insane. Also, because entropy must increase, when two black holes merge, the final black hole surface area must be greater than its constituent black holes. This is a real constraint on black hole mergers. Not only this, but black holes cannot contain photons larger than wavelength A, so they must leak these in the form of Hawking radiation. There is a famous paradox put forth by James Maxwell in regards to entropy. Consider two chambers of gas connected by a valve. Now, a demon peers into both chambers, and whenever a gas molecule is going towards chamber A, it lets it through. Eventually, all gas from chamber B is in chamber A. If Maxwell's demon halves the volume of 1 mole of gas, this decreases the entropy by Avogadro's number times kb ln 2. This seems like a proof by contradiction statement, showing entropy can't be a real quantity, but that's because we aren't considering the demon as part of this closed system. To make a choice about when to open or close the valve, the demon must perform computations on the molecules' positions and velocities. The demon must store that information. The demon can peer into the chambers to get this information of an entropy of kb ln 2 per bit. Reversing 1 mole of gas requires at least Avogadro's bits of information to do this, and therefore the entropy of the demon's brain must increase by Avogadro's number times kb ln 2 to perform the calculation, completely covering the entropy lost. There is a workaround, but we will soon see why this can't work. It is possible for the demon to measure the particles without increasing entropy, if the demon copies that information 100% efficiently. We can imagine the entropy, those NA bits of information, flowing from the system into the demon's brain. But that means the demon must store those NA bits of information forever. As once it forgets them, the entropy of the universe is gained once again. Also, nothing stores information at 100% efficiency. If the mechanism for storing the information is the same as the one for erasing, like flipping a switch, then the mechanism can't tell if it's erasing or writing. Storing a bit increases entropy by kb ln 2 regardless. In a famous number file video, Tony Padilla introduces Graham's number, one of the largest numbers used in a proof, in a powerful way. Because it's so big, your head would collapse into a black hole before you could memorize it. This is, as insane as it sounds, absolutely true, and we can intuit why. A number has to be stored on a series of digits, and a number with n digits requires n digits to store, and therefore has an entropy of S equals to n kb ln 10. Nothing stores as much entropy as a black hole, so therefore numbers have a minimum mass. You would either need a storage device more massive to store the number, or whatever process of calculating and storing that number will be, it pushes enough heat into the storage device that its mass from E equals mc squared collapses it into a black hole. Making logical leaps like this is the true power of entropy and why studying statistical mechanics is beautiful. This video is largely based on concepts in thermal physics, which my university professor and I highly recommend. A couple of the anecdotes were taken straight from the book, since I couldn't think of anything better, and it showcases tools that probe ever deeper topics in thermal physics. This video is also an entry for the Summer of Maths Exposition 3 contest, which seems to be the only thing motivating me to make videos in my busy life. I've seen people ask for a regular upload schedule, but there are only a finite number of physics ideas that aren't explained well. If I make a video that isn't good on that topic, then I wouldn't feel happy uploading it, knowing I'll have to replace it eventually. I hope this video was as informative as it was for me researching it. Entropy is one of the most philosophically empowering topics in physics, connecting disparate intuitions from logic, thermodynamics, and combinatorics. Thank you for watching. Have a good evening.